powers in the life of Sarah Hughes. Last night, she was in Detroit. Before leaving, she signed some autographs for her adoring fans. Then onto the bus for a trip to the airport. When she arrived, there was no need for help with her bags.
Do you see?
Then she passed the time with a fellow gold medalist as she rode the charter flight here to Columbus for tonight's competition. But when she got to the hotel well after midnight, she realized even gold medalists have to wait in line. For Sarah, it's been one more long night, a night she would never have imagined for herself only 10 months ago. As children, we're taught to dream. Dream of a place where the impossible is possible. And for any young girl who has ever laced a figure skate, the dream is to be Olympic champion. To be Peggy. And Dorothy, Christy, and Tara. Every 4 years, the door opens up for one more dreamer, a dreamer with one chance, one opportunity to seize everything they ever wanted.
My dream is to be in the Olympics and get a gold medal. I can't wait for that to happen.
Those were the dreams of a six-year-old from Long Island named Sarah Hughes. 10 years later, Salt Lake City would be the place where her dreams became reality. Lost in the shadows of Michelle Kwan and Sasha Cohen, Sarah would skate the performance of a lifetime, proving that even in the real world, fairy tale dreams can come true.
Olympics and get a gold medal. I can't wait for that to happen.
What?
Fast forward to this morning. Only 9 hours after checking into the hotel, Sarah takes the ice for practice. And a life that is perceived by many to be glamorous and carefree reveals its more human side. Tired both physically and mentally, Sarah must battle to find the energy needed to be the skater everyone expects her to be. From Nationwide Arena in Columbus, Ohio, NBC Sports presents the Hallmark Skaters Championship. And Sarah Hughes headlines the event, the gold medalist, of course, and she will meet Irina Slutskaya, who won silver behind her in Salt Lake City. It should be an exciting live night of skating as we see the interpretive free skate for both ladies' singles and men's singles tonight. Tom Hammond joined by Sandra Bezick. And Sandra, this is an unusual event in that we're seeing both Olympic-eligible amateur skaters skate against professionals.
It's a hybrid competition designed to
to please skating fans, where we can see our favorite pro and eligible skaters competing head-to-head. And the rules have been modified in a way to control what we will see, because the jumps have been controlled. Only 3 or 4 jumps will be allowed in each of the events, but the focus will be on artistry and interpretation and the performance.
Well, Sarah Hughes has, of course, been the focus of all the attention. She's had a big weekend already. She did skate in Detroit last night. She finished second. Many of these skaters did take part in that competition in Detroit, getting here well past midnight, so we'll take a look at their stamina, see how they hold up. And also for Sarah Hughes, the big weekend, because she found out yesterday she'd been accepted to Harvard. Not sure she's going to go yet or not, but she has been accepted. And her main competition appears to come from Irina Sliskaya, just as it did in Salt Lake City, where Irina won the silver. Many in her home country of Russia thought she should have been awarded the gold medal, of course, as the controversy never stops in the sport of figure skating. So Sarah Hughes, though, has been impressive in the fact that she is trying to overcome an injury. She pulled a muscle behind her right knee just a couple of months ago, so she's just now coming back into competition.
That's right, and she did debut her short program here and skated a performance that she was very pleased with.
The short performances were earlier today, and after the short program, here are the standings as we approach the ladies' interpretive free skate, which we'll be seeing live. Sarah Hughes is the leader. Sliskaya second. Yuka Sato is third. And Maria Butryskaya in fourth position. So as Sarah Hughes took the ice today for that short program, one wondered about her stamina. We saw how tired she looked at practice this morning. Would she be able to pull it off, overcoming the injury of a couple of months ago and the fatigue? Here is the short program earlier today from Sarah Hughes.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first competitor in the ladies' short program from the United States, Sarah Hughes.
What about billboards?
Robin Wagner choreographed it, and she opens with her easiest jump, the double axel. Now the most difficult, the triple Lutz combination.
It's been a while since we've seen Sarah in action. Salt Lake City for most of us, and she looked good.
Lovely footwork. Yeah, footwork into her triple flip. Struggling with that knee injury, and the hardest thing has been consistent training. You know, you lose your rhythm. Thank you. She looks relieved and pleased, and she should be. Very nice debut.
Sarah Hughes off to a good start. And that good start in the short program did put the 17-year-old high school senior Sarah Hughes in first place after the technical program. However, at the moment, Sarah Hughes has not shown up here at the arena. It's somewhat of a mystery. Let's see if Andrea Joyce can solve it for us. Andrea?
Well, unfortunately, I can't, Tom. We just received word that Sarah has not yet left the hotel, which is really only about a 5 or 10 minute drive from the arena, but she hasn't left yet. Now, as you said, she was tired this morning. She's been in great spirits, though. She's been tailed by autograph seekers everywhere she's gone, and perhaps that's been the delay, that there are just so many kids out there wanting her autograph. She just hasn't been able to make it into the building, but it is a bit unusual that she's not here yet, scheduled to skate in about an hour and a half. Back to you.
All right, Andrea, that's the story of the night so far. Sarah Hughes missing as of now. The Hallmark Skaters Championship is brought to you by Hallmark. This holiday, send a card. They'll never forget you remembered. By Russell Stover Candies. Russell Stover, handcrafted chocolates since 1923. By Home-Baked Classics from Pillsbury. Delicious dinner rolls and biscuits that bake up in minutes. And by Prudential Financial, a rock-solid leader in financial services. Choose Prudential Financial to help you grow and protect your wealth. We're back live in Ohio's capital city for the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Irina Slutskaya, one of the favorites to take this championship, in second place. And starting her technical program with a problem, the wrong music.
Well, she wasn't here for practice earlier today, so they didn't know which program was which,
okay.
And they did put
we'll
on
fix that.
Their her interpretive program instead of the short program music, but she did well anyway with a beautiful triple lutz, triple toe combination. And then shortly later, bit of trouble here, a triple flip that got a little too close to the boards and wasn't able to hold it.
This earlier today in the short program, and after that short program, Slutskaya, who won the silver medal in Salt Lake City, is in second place here behind Sarah Hughes. Yuka Sato and Maria Butryskaya, third and fourth, will be seeing live the free skate from the ladies a little later on tonight. And first we'll see the men, and Michael Weiss, who from the Washington, D.C. area, the United States representative, skated very well, and he has the lead after the short program. And as we take a look at some of the highlights of the short program today, Alexa Yagudin, the gold medalist from Salt Lake City, was first to skate today. He, too, coming back from injury, a serious hip injury.
Opened with a beautiful triple-triple combination. But with that injury, he has not been training much at all, and he's been willing these performances. Takeshi Honda had problems. Opened with a quad. Not today.
And of course, Todd Eldridge, one of the most decorated U.S. skaters ever, six-time U.S. champion. But he's been in the news in a different way. Yesterday, he announced that he was severing all ties with the United States Figure Skating Association. He's had an ongoing controversy with them about whether he would be eligible to skate in the amateur competition. And for the story on that, let's go to Todd now with Andrea Joyce. Andrea?
All right, thanks, Tom. Todd, you told us that the U.S. Figure Skating Association made you an offer, rescinded it, and in essence it said you're not welcome to compete in any of their events. Are you angered by what's happened?
Well, it's definitely upsetting, you know, to be in that situation. You know, I've competed for more than 10 years, you know, in their events, and you know, to have an offer rescinded like that is, it's kind of difficult.
Six-time national champion, you wanted to compete again in this year's nationals. Is this hurtful because that option's been taken away from you?
Yeah, you know, it's true. I mean, it's definitely hurtful. You know, it's something that would have been nice. It would have been fun to do. But, you know, I don't feel like at this point I have the support from them. And, you know, going into a national championship, you need that support. And you know, they pretty much left me with no choice.
And as a result, you've turned pro.
Right, right. I mean, they really left me with no choice. I mean, basically, I'm going to turn pro and take my, you know, career in a new direction.
What about the Olympics?
The Olympics is another story. You know, I mean, the Olympics has been a difficult thing for me, but, you know, I'm looking forward to the future for me in skating. And, you know, if that's professional skating, then that's where it lies, and that's great.
You think you'd want to do another Olympics?
I don't know. You know, I'm getting up there in age. You know, they said past Olympics, but, you know, I don't know. It would be difficult for me to, you know, at this stage in my life to, you know, go back and put in that much training for that.
All right. We wish you the best of luck tonight. Thanks.
Thank you.
Back to you, Tom.
All right, Andrea. And there's Alexa Yagudin, who lived the Olympic dream that Todd Elders was never able to realize, winning the gold medal in Salt Lake City. He's in second place behind Michael Weiss as we come to the men's free skate. We'll be back to see them in action in just a moment. Tom Hammond, Sandra Bezick, Andrea Joyce back live at the Nationwide Arena in Columbus, Ohio for the Hallmark Skaters Championship. This arena home to the NHL Columbus Blue Jackets. But right now the men's singles finger skaters on the ice warming up for their free skate. There's Michael Weiss, who's the leader after the short program. A little surprising that he is the leader.
He skated beautifully. Gorgeous quad, just right on top of things. And you know, he's an interesting competitor because he's got all the talent in the world, but he's the first one to admit that he's inconsistent. You never know what to expect with him.
Now, speaking of what to expect, he has some crazy move that we might see tonight.
He does. It's called...
Tornado?
Tornado. I was going to say hurricane. It's a tornado.
No, don't get that wrong.
His version of a backflip. Look out, Scott Hamilton.
Now, Sandra, a few minutes ago, we heard Todd Eldridge, as we look at Alexa Yagudin, heard Todd Eldridge talk about how he was going to skate now as a professional. He has all the attributes to be a fine professional, isn't he? First among those being the fact that the fans adore him.
They adore him because he brings so much integrity to each performance. You know that he's come prepared, that he cares every time, that he gives everything he has. And I think that that's his legacy, and he will continue that as a professional.
And Yagudin, the gold medalist who is brilliant at times, was told just a couple of months ago that he had a potentially career-ending hip injury, a congenital deformity in his hip, and he pulled out of some competitions. He's been trying to get back, and he has returned. He skated last night in Detroit. He'll have skated two programs here in Columbus. How is he doing it with all the pain?
It's tough. He's going through a really confusing time because just 9 months ago, he was Olympic champion and, you know, had a cocky swagger about him. And then he finds out that he may not have a very lasting career here. He hasn't been able to train. He's been... Whoa.
Oh, there's the tornado.
Alexei's been trying to will these performances. And he's afraid, he's nervous, and he's in a lot of pain.
Now, while the men continue their warm-ups, we're told that Sarah Hughes has arrived in the arena, and she's with Andrea.
All right, Tom. Sarah, we're glad you're here. We were getting a little worried about you.
Oh,
you're here. You're here. That's the most important thing. You debuted a brand-new short program, and you're in first place after this short. How relieved are you to have that part of the competition over?
I was glad just to put my short program out there, and, you know, I'm looking forward to improving my programs, and I think that was a great start for my program, and excited to perform my interpretive program here tonight.
You've been off for a couple of months with an injury layoff. What has it been like for you to be out there physically and emotionally?
Yeah, it's been great getting back and just getting my competitive legs back under me, and tonight just I'm looking forward to having a lot of fun, and I'm really happy just to be back skating.
Good luck. Thanks.
Thank you.
Back to you, Tom.
All right, Andrea, and she may be relieved to get that short program out of the way. We're relieved she's here.
Yes.
We'll be seeing her skate later on, and as we look at Michael Weiss, the men's leader. We didn't talk about Takeshi Honda from Japan, who just missed in Salt Lake City of becoming the first Japanese man to ever win an Olympic figure skating medal. He finished in fourth place.
And he's another very talented skater, but an inconsistent competitor. Again, you just never know what's going to happen. He's got all the goods. It's just a matter of getting it out there with a strong short program and free program.
And struggled a bit in the short program earlier today, which is why he finds himself in fourth place coming into the free skate and first to skate in the free program. Eldridge skates second, Weiss skates third, and Yagudin will be fourth and last. This counts for two-thirds of the final score.
You
In this interpretive program, the men are restricted to only four jumps.
Japan, Takashi Honda.
And here is 21-year-old Takashi Honda from Japan, though he trains in Ontario, Canada.
By Brian Orser, opening with the triple axel. That's what he needed earlier today.
Well, inconsistent, you say.
The Orserism.
In 1988, Brian Orser won the silver medal as Brian Boitano won the gold, the Battle of the Bryans.
He also won the silver medal in 84 to Scott Hamilton's gold. Triple combination. Just one. Takashi Honda of Japan. A well-rounded performance. Happier with that.
Yep. Much better than his short program earlier today. And next to take the ice will be Todd Eldridge. We'll see him skate when we return to the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Back live in Columbus, you've heard and read so much about judging that it's a pretty simple proposition here in Columbus. The International Skating Union judges preside. There are five of them, and all their marks count. No computer selecting randomly. All five judges' marks count, and we identify each of them by their country. As Takeshi Honda awaits his marks, two marks will be given, skating techniques and presentation. And for techniques, 5-6 across the board.
Takeshi's first up, so that's why the consistent marks.
5-7, consistent again for presentation.
Thank you. Our next competitor from the United States, Todd Eldridge.
And now here's Todd Eldridge, now 31 years old, 10th in Salt Lake City when he was hoping to realize that Olympic dream, but one of the most beloved skaters in American skating history.
Thank you.
judge in his first official skate as a professional gets a standing ovation.
And you can be sure he's going to have a fantastic pro career.
The fans have shown their appreciation. We'll check the judges' marks when we come back. Michael Weiss, the leader in the men's competition, scheduled to skate next in the free skate. But first, let's check the scores for Todd Eldridge.
The marks for Todd Eldridge for skating techniques.
Todd had a really solid skate, but his jumps were not the most difficult. He had a triple axel that was a little off. Triple sow cow, triple toe loop.
None of that mattered to the
there
fans.
There you go. But the marks go up for presentation.
And it temporarily puts him in first place ahead of Takeshi Honda. And so here's Michael Weiss.
Ladies and gentlemen, our next competitor from the United States, Michael Weiss.
26 years old, trains in Fairfax, Virginia, married with a couple of kids. And I suspect we'll see the tornado early as he skates to the Rolling Stones.
The eligible skaters are looking pro, and the pro skaters are looking eligible.
What would you expect from a man who married his choreographer? Lisa Thorne.
Look at that. That's great. You can do that in hockey skates. Did you know that?
I did not. I wouldn't want to try it.
Of a whole lot of fun and some good content.
Now what do you call that?
You name it.
Thank you. had a little touch of Philippe Candeloro in it. And a crowd pleaser from Michael Weiss.
This is a tough room, though. They're not as quick to stand as they were for Todd.
Now some momentum as some stand, but not all.
Well, it was a whole lot of fun and a lot of good content, but in between all that, the skating was pretty straightforward. It was not as difficult choreographically as one would think.
So Michael Weiss trying to hold on to the lead. As we mentioned, born in Washington, D.C. and lives in Fairfax, Virginia, and Washington, D.C., the site of the World Championships in 2003. Alexei Yagudin, the gold medalist in Salt Lake City, will be the final men's skater, trying to overcome Michael Weiss, the leader going into the free skate and awaiting his scores after that free skate performance. Well, the tornado hit early.
It's so hard to come up with something new in figure skating.
A hug for his wife, Lisa, there. And here's the tornado.
It really is hard to create something new, and he's figured this one out. Backflip with a twist. He's still touching his hands down. Uh-huh. I bet he's going to learn how to do that with no hands at all. And then by redesigning his blades, he's been able to do this move. Really great. Doesn't that look...
Yeah.
Fantastic down the ice.
How do the judges?
It looks like fun.
How do the judges, though, judge something like the tornado, that move?
I think you give it a creative mark, but not necessarily a technically difficult mark.
The marks for Michael Weiss for skating technique.
5.8s and 5.7s.
And those marks should be that high because the jumps that he did do were very difficult.
Now presentation.
They liked it.
Canadian judge has him third. Everyone else has him in first place. Michael Weiss putting the pressure on Alexei Yagudin, the final skater, the gold medalist at the 2002 Olympics.
Our final competitor from Russia, Alexei Yagudin.
Alexei does not like to lose. He is a very, very determined competitor. He knows he hasn't trained. He knows all the other guys have.
And that hip injury, really being tested now with three programs in 2 days. Gutting it out.
trademark footwork.
Makes it look easy, doesn't it?
There is so much substance to his work, and I love that he's just come out in a black sweater, black pants, and he's letting his skating and his emotions take center stage.
Sandra, I thought he responded like an Olympic champion.
And he always does, and that's why he is an Olympic champion. This is a personal victory for him, regardless of the marks. He's out there, he did it, he didn't know if he could.
And he gets a standing ovation from the fans here in Columbus.
He's passionate. Devoted. I mean, he puts his heart out there, and it's an intelligent performance. It's well thought out. Technically exact, but yet emotionally free.
But was it enough to catch Michael Weiss, who watches from the wings? His father, Greg, by his side. Michael's dad, Greg, a member of the 64 U.S. Olympic gymnastics team.
So that's where all those tricks come from. In the jeans. Coach Tatiana Tarasova.
Michael looks fairly confident. His dad, not so. This is a tough decision for the judges.
What a contrast of work. All excellent. Exciting to judge, I bet.
Here are the marks for skating techniques. Oh, 5.9s, a couple of 5.8s.
5.8, 5.9.
And for presentation.
Oh! There you go.
Two perfect sixes. And that'll do it. That'll make Alexei Yagudin the champion, despite the pressure put on by Michael Weiss. And Andrea is with the champion.
Alexa, congratulations. You have been struggling with a painful hip injury. How were you able to block all of that out and come out here and win this program and win the competition?
I guess that's why I won Olympics, because I'm able to motivate myself in the right time. And anyway, I had a lot of pain, but I just had myself like, okay, let's pretend that that's Olympic Games and you have to do it like every time perfect. And it wasn't that easy, but we went through that.
This is your third competition in a week. We saw you limping backstage. How are you holding up physically?
Well, I'm done with the competing for this year for right now so far. So I'm just going to take a lot of rest, and I'm just really glad to be back with NBC, those company who actually translate the Olympics. And it's great to be united.
The doctors have said that this is a serious injury. It could be career-threatening. How difficult has it been for you to deal with that? I read something where you said it's like darkness over you.
Well, so far, you know, what I realized that we can't, the pro athletes, they can't avoid serious injuries. We're fighting against pain, and hopefully we'll get through that.
Well, we wish you the best of luck. Thanks so much.
Thanks a lot.
Tom?
All right, Andrea. The heart of a champion. We heard a lot about that, that phrase used a lot. We saw it in the person of Alexei Yagudin here at the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Final standings. Alexei Yagudin is the champion. Takes home a $30,000 check for winning the competition. Michael Weiss second, Todd Eldridge third, Takeshi Honda is fourth. And still to come, live, the ladies.
Okay.
We're back live at the Hallmark Skaters Championship. And there is Sarah Hughes, the leader in the ladies' competition. The ladies' free skate will be coming up next. And here at the Hallmark Skaters Championship, here's a Hallmark moment. This is Michael Weiss and his patented tornado.
Judge number two, Ms. Taffy Holliday, United States.
There it is. And right now, Michael is with Andrea.
Judge number three,
all right, Tom, Michael, we got to ask you about the tornado. Where did it come from?
Oh, it was wild. You know, my dad has an Olympic gymnastics background. We started training it this summer, and it was something new and innovative. You know, nobody's ever tried anything like that before in ice skating, and I wanted to be the first to do it. It's scary. It really is. The first one you try is pretty crazy, but I was happy to pull it off tonight.
Well, you looked like you were having so much fun out there. Is it possible you had a little bit too much fun? You weren't able to hold on to the lead?
I don't know. You know, with these interpretive events, you never really know what the judges are looking for. But I went out and had a blast. You know, I had a great time. The crowd was behind me. I did the first tornado ever done on ice and skated clean the rest of the way. So, I mean, all I can be happy with is the way I skated. You know, leave the rest up to the judges. You never know what's going to happen with them.
All right, thanks. It was a lot of fun to watch.
Thank you.
Tom?
All right, Andrea, I agree. It was fun to watch. As Sarah Hughes and the ladies get set to take the ice in their warm-up for their interpretive free skate. Sarah Hughes, Maria Butkerskaya, just to her right. There's Irina Sutskaya.
Yeah, I heard you.
And Yuka Sato is bound to be around there somewhere. She's been the busiest person at the Hallmark Skaters Championship, competing with her husband, Jason Dungeon, in the pairs, which you can see tomorrow afternoon here on NBC. And getting ready to compete also here in the ladies' singles, the former world champion from Japan.
This will be her fourth performance today.
And a warm-up now underway. Irina Sutskaya, was she a redhead in Salt Lake City?
No, I don't think so. In third place, you can girls just want to have fun. We're all guilty.
And Sarah Hughes, you know, I haven't been around her, but a little bit the last couple of days, or today, really. But she hasn't changed a bit, has she?
We were talking about that earlier today, Tom, where you expect some kind of change 9 months after winning the Olympics, some kind of, you know, star entrance when she walks into a building, and yet she's just the same kid going to school. Charming.
Just wholesome,
everything that
normal.
You see. Yeah, normal.
A senior. She won't be 18 until May at Great Neck North High School on Long Island, New York. And as we noted earlier, accepted yesterday to Harvard. She's also visited Yale, Princeton, her dad's alma mater, Cornell. But the front runner might be Columbia, because if she goes to Columbia in Midtown Manhattan, she can still train with Robin Wagner in Hackensack, New Jersey. I asked Robin, what will you do if Sarah decides to go to Harvard, to Cambridge, Massachusetts, to go to college? He says, I don't know, that's something we'll have to face, because with a husband and a family, Robin said, moving is not an option. That's Robin.
Okay. And Sarah, even right now, is having difficulty juggling school and skating. Her dad was saying earlier today that when she's at school, she feels guilty that she's missing training, and when she's training, she feels guilty that she's missing her schoolwork. So it's not easy. But it's admirable that she's doing both.
Her dad is sort of her manager and protector, guarding her from...
As dad should be.
Yeah, from everyone, including a potential boyfriend, I have a feeling. But she is a delight. As we look at her chief rival, Irina Sutskaya, silver medalist behind Sarah in Salt Lake City.
Feisty personality. Mm-hmm.
The red hair suits her.
It does. It certainly suits her personality. She did finish third at the Cup of Russia a couple of weeks ago, which was a surprising disappointment. She's erratic.
Well, she's very athletic, and Sarah, of course, had that Olympic program, the most challenging for a lady ever. And then there's the other side of the coin, or the end of the spectrum, and that's Yuka Sato, who is as graceful and lyrical in her skating as anyone you can ever see.
And we always call her the skater's skater, because she has beautiful edge quality, and she just is right into the ice. But on the other hand, her upper body is all air and lightness, just beautiful to watch.
Well, we'll take a break, and when we come back to Columbus, Ohio, we will have live the ladies' free skate at the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Back live at the Hallmark Skaters Championship, Tom Hammond, Sandra Bezick, Andrea Joyce, as we come to the ladies' free skate, counting two-thirds of the final score. And in the skate order for the ladies' free skate, that will be the first skater, Maria Butkerskaya. Butkerskaya first, then Yuka Sato, Sarah Hughes, and Irina Sutskaya skates last.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia, Maria Butkerskaya.
Maria, now 30 years old and has turned professional. Three-time European champion, five-time Russian champion. She was sixth in Salt Lake City.
Maria is another inconsistent competitor. You never quite know what to expect. Triple toe loop. The men were allowed 4 jumps, the women are allowed 3. Triple loop. Most of her own choreography, and she's skating for Shakira. Eyes like yours.
Maria Butryskaya of Russia.
A good performance for Maria. I think the judges are going to have a little trouble finding marks for it because all the dancing is upper body movement and not necessarily footwork.
Yuka Sato will be skating next. And as Yuka stretches to get ready, Butryskaya will come to the sideline, and we'll be back to check her marks in just a moment. Live shot of Yuka Sato of Japan, who won this competition last year. She'll be next to skate in the free skate. Maria Butryskaya awaits her mark. She was the first skater.
And Maria had a pretty good skate. The only jump that she had a little bit of trouble with was her opening jump, the triple toe loop. Slightly cautious entrance, not enough height, therefore not enough time to get the free leg out. You professionals have to learn what to do in order to compete and what pleases the judges. Michael Wise mentioned it earlier. And the judges, certainly an ISU panel, are going to look for more skating-based movement as opposed to just arms and upper body.
And here are the marks.
Five, 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 five.
The skating techniques, 5-5 five, five across the board.
And as the lady who's first up, her jump, her marks are going to be very consistent.
5-7, 5-6, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7, 5-7,
Maria, we know that you've been working as a commentator. What would you say about your performance?
You know, I commentate in Russian. I speak English. It's not good. I'm so sorry. But
were you satisfied, happy with the way you skated?
I'm happy, but yes, a little bit was difficult because, you know, it's I come Russia just one day before, and you know,
jet lag,
change time, and right now in Russian it's so early. I think 5 morning, and you know, I don't understand, but I'm happy.
Okay, congratulations. Thank you.
Thank you,
Tom.
All right, Andrea, a little jet lag, but she skated pretty well. And here's Yuka Sato. As we said, she was the 2001 Hallmark champion. Won the world championship in 1994 from Tokyo, now living with her husband, Jason Dungeon, who also is her coach and her pairs partner in Bloomfield Hills, Michigan.
And as a professional, she just gets better every year.
Yesterday, it's not about the jumps, it's about the interpretation of the music. Maybe not all the coaches and judges would agree with that, but certainly if that's her aim, she does it as well as anyone.
Thank you.
Beautiful.
Yuka Sato.
And the people are standing. They appreciate the quality.
We'll have her marks in a moment, and now only two skaters remain, the Salt Lake rivals, Sarah Hughes and Arina Slutskaya. Sarah Hughes is next. Ladies' championship still up for grabs. We're down to the final two skaters in the ladies' competition. That's Sarah Hughes. She'll be skating next as Yuka Sato awaits her marks.
There isn't a skater in the building who doesn't just love to watch Yuka skate. She has equal parts strength and a gentleness about her.
That's her husband, coach, and pairs partner, Jason Dungeon, at her side. Here's some of what you're talking about.
It's infectious. You know, when I watch her, I want to skate, and I think all skaters feel that way.
I draw the line there.
She's reminiscent of Dorothy Hamill.
Look at the joy on her face.
It is fun, trust me.
I'll take your word. And here are Yuka's marks. 5'8" from the Canadian judge.
5'6", 5'7". As Jason says, very nice. They are nice.
There
you go.
Couple of 5'9"s. And that will put her temporarily, at least in first place, with Sarah Hughes to skate next. Sarah, the leader after the short program, and before Sarah skates, let's go down to Andrea.
Yuka, a very long day for you. What does it mean to you to be able to top it off, finish off the day with a standing ovation?
I had to really think hard to remember all the steps and everything, since this is the fourth number for me today. But I was really focused, and at the end of it was really, really a happy moment, and I don't regret any moment of that.
You skated four programs because you're in the pairs and the singles. Had you ever done that before? Four programs in a day?
No, I have never skated four numbers a day.
How are you feeling physically?
My legs are a little tight. I think I'll feel it tomorrow more than that. But
just a little bit?
A lot.
And it was a mental challenge.
Yes, it was, but I really try to talk myself into pacing myself and everything, and I did. So
we like seeing you four times on the ice. Thanks so much. Tom?
All right, Andrea, we'll see Yuka and Jason in the pairs tomorrow afternoon on NBC.
From the United States, Sarah Hughes.
From the musical Fosse. Sarah says she has not performed this number since exhibitions at the Olympics. Should bring back some good feelings.
If she can even remember them. She's on a cloud.
Opening with a double axel.
Thank you.
close to the board. The little girls in the building have just rushed down the aisles and are hanging over the boards. Talk about a role model, huh?
Yeah. Well, considering the injury and the lost training time and the fatigue from last night and arriving early this morning.
She hung on right until the very end,
yeah.
The last jump.
But she may have left the door open, huh?
She has left the door open.
That means that Irina Sliskaya, her Olympic rival, has a chance to claim the championship.
And she knows it.
But she knew it in Salt Lake, too.
That's right.
I was thinking, like, it was okay. I heard you scream double.
And I would never scream.
I was like, okay.
Yeah. Her coach screamed double when she was going into the triple toe because I guess she saw how close she was to the boards and perhaps how tired. And her student ignored her. And that's a true competitor.
Is there a message there?
Messages, she doesn't give up. Yeah, she really rushed that timing in order to get it in before getting to the boards. Teacher knows best.
Hi, everybody at home.
It was really fun. It was a very fun performance.
So, Irina Sluskaya, who won the silver behind Sarah in Salt Lake City, will be the final skater with a chance to claim the title.
The marks for Sarah.
And here are Sarah Hughes' marks.
Five, six, five, seven.
She needed that jump.
Five, six, five, seven. The marks for presentation. Five, seven.
Little mix.
Yeah, 5'9".
Five, nine.
Down to a 5'6". And only two first place votes. Which keeps Yuka Sato ahead of Sarah Hughes. Is Yuka backstage? So there are the current standings. With Irina Sliskaya, the final skater on the ice.
She can't quite believe it. But it was deserved.
Ladies and gentlemen, from Russia, Irina Sliskaya.
Thank you.
one of the nicest performances I've seen from Irina.
Irina Slutskaya of Russia, is it enough?
I think she's given the judges exactly what they want. Three beautiful and difficult jumps, a well-rounded program, good spins, drama.
Yuka Sato is the one that Irina is trying to catch. Yuka with a beautiful free skate is the leader.
If there's a difference, it's just that Irina's jumps were a little bit more difficult than Yuka's.
And the exuberant Sarah Hughes always. Irina signing a few autographs, milking the moment.
It's great for these young children to see these champions in person. It's got to be so inspiring.
Remember, Irina was the final skater in Salt Lake City and had the gold medal within her grasp.
She didn't let it go this time.
No.
I mean, regardless of what the judges do, she did not give away this competition. Skating is such an exciting sport on television, but for these young girls to see it in person, there is a difference, isn't there, in person?
Uh-huh.
You hear the edges and
yeah, the sound
really,
is one of the first things I noticed.
And the speed. Yuka's speed, wonderful.
Yuka telling us that she and Jason are remodeling the kitchen, so she's hoping to take home a hefty paycheck.
And that's why she was working four times today.
The marks for Irina Slutskaya for skating techniques.
Continue to sign while her marks come up. That's
five,
confidence
seven,
for you.
5-6, 5-8, 5-8, 5-8.
5-8, a 7 and a 6.
The marks for presentation.
For presentation. 2 5-9s.
5-8, 5-6, 5-9, 5-9, 5-8.
But Yuka, it's not enough for Slutskaya. Yuka Sato is the winner. I don't even know if she knows it yet. Does she realize it?
This is incredible for her.
Here's Andrea.
Yuka, congratulations. You know you won?
I just realized what happened. Oh, my gosh.
Are you surprised?
Yes,
I am.
But
I think it's good once in a while.
You won this competition last year. What is it about this event that brings out the best in you?
I would have to say it's a pure luck. Hallmark Challenge always gives me a really good luck.
You had these four programs that you had to skate today. You got out there after a very long day. You told us earlier you had never done that before, skated four programs in 24 hours like that. Should you do it more often?
I'm going to have to consider that after tonight because I'm a little bit tired right now, but it's not a bad idea, I guess.
You guys are remodeling your kitchen. Is this all good in that effort?
I think it will definitely help.
And was it worth all the pain today?
I would have to say it was just in the last minute, right before I got on the ice, before the first pairs. I had to ask myself, why did I even think about it? But after all, I think I still made the right decision.
All right, congratulations again. And we are going to step right over here. Hi, Sarah.
Hi, how are you?
Thank you for making room for me over here. Your assessment. How you did today. Not a whole lot of training time for you with the injury. How did you do?
Yeah, you know, this is a very fun program for me. I really enjoy skating it, and it's just very showy, and it shows a different side than my competitive programs. And, you know, I competed yesterday also, so just doing three programs in 2 days has been a great wake-up for me after being off competition for a long
time. See, you're young. You can handle all of this in the last 24 hours, right?
I'm having a great time. This is wonderful.
With Nationals just about a month away, what does this tell you about where you are?
You know, I have a lot of work to do when I go home. I have a clear picture of where I want to be, and I see a lot of things that I can improve between now and a national.
Tara Lipinski won her gold medal at the Olympics, and she walked away on top. Where does the motivation come from to stick around?
You know, my goals aren't always set with medals or with titles. I really enjoy the thrill of competition, and I really enjoy the grind of training. And that's why it's so wonderful just to be back and to be able to share this with everybody.
Well, we're glad to see you back on the ice.
Thank you very much.
All right, back to you, Tom.
All right, Andrea. So final standings in the ladies' competition. Yuka Sato can put another cabinet in the kitchen. She wins the ladies' championship. Slutskaya again settles for second, as she did in Salt Lake. Sarah Hughes third, Maria Butryskaya fourth. We'll be back to Columbus in just a moment. The Hallmark Skaters Championship has been brought to you by Hallmark. Capture your holiday memories with a Hallmark keepsake ornament. By Polo.com. Shop the world of Ralph Lauren just a click away. By Sun America, the retirement specialist. And by McDonald's. Yuka Sato has claimed the championship in the ladies' competition at the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Arina Slutskaya skated last, had a chance to take the title, but again comes up second. Right now she's with Andrea Joyce.
All right, Tom, sorry about that. Irina, you went out there, the door was open, skating last. What was going through your mind just as you took the ice?
Oh, well, you know, it's my favorite number, skating last, and I'm just having fun, you know. I start the season late, and, you know, I'm like skating, you know, not really nice, but I'm skating better, better, and better, and I just want to prove to myself I can do it, and I can do it good.
And we're glad you're feeling better as well.
Yeah, thank you so much.
All right, back to you, Tom.
All right, Andrea. And we hope you'll join us tomorrow here on NBC tomorrow afternoon for the pairs competition at the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Tomorrow, Olympic gold medalists Jamie Salle and David Peltier take the ice in Columbus for their first U.S. competition since Salt Lake. They'll be joined by current world champion Shannon Zhao in an Olympic rematch. The best pair skaters in the world tomorrow at the Hallmark Skaters Championship. And that'll do it for tonight from the Hallmark Skaters Championship. Tom Hammond for Sandra Bezek and Andrea Joyce saying so long from Columbus.